In this question, it is saying an electric dipole is placed at an angle 30 degree to a non-uniform electric field, then dipole will experience. We need to check the translational force and the direction of translational force as well as the torque if it is acting on it. So if we visualize the situation given here, if this is the direction of electric field, and from the direction of electric field a dipole is placed, and the direction of this dipole is making an angle 30 degree to the non-uniform electric field. Here this is non-uniform electric field. Now in this situation, we know whenever in non-uniform electric field a dipole is placed, it always experiences a force. And the component of force along the direction of electric field we can write as we already discussed, the electric force on a dipole placed in non-uniform electric field is given as, here the force we can write as in magnitude dipole moment dot product with dE by dx. Here due to this dot product we can say one cos 30 degree will be there, and this will be P dE by dx cos 30 degree, and this is the force along the direction of electric field, because on this dipole if this is the positive pole and this is the negative pole, we know on negative side the force is in the direction opposition to electric field, and on the positive side the force is along the direction of electric field. Here it is F1, this is F2, and obviously due to non-uniform electric field F1 is not equal to F2, we can say as electric field is non-uniform, here F1 is not equals to F2, so we can say dipole will experience a translational force. Or which is mod of F1 minus F2, and is given as PD by dx cos 30 degree, this is P dot D by dx. This is the magnitude we consider, because P dot E is the potential energy and negative of the derivative of potential energy or negative of the potential gradient is the net force acting on this. Here also we can see as the two forces are not acting along the same line, so they are acting along the different lines of action, so there must be a torque also which is present in this case, so we can write as F1 and F2 are not acting along same lines of action, so there will be a torque due to these forces present on dipole. So it will have a tendency of clockwise rotation of this dipole. These forces will tend this dipole to rotate clockwise. And here we can say this torque is clockwise, as we can see in this figure. So it will be experiencing a translational force as well as a torque. So here we can say answer to this question is option C.